Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name's Leigh Fuge and I'm here with mgrmusic.com, and in this lesson today we're going to learn 7 tips, tricks and techniques in the style of blues legend B.B. King. For the video today, there is only one guitar that I could possibly use, which is my Epiphone Lucille. This is the B.B. King signature model. This is plugged into the Blackstar Silverline Standard, which is mic'd up with a Lewitt Audio LCT440 condenser microphone, and my voice is being recorded with a Rode Go clip-on mic. Okay, so the first B.B. King thing we're going to learn today is his use of the major and minor pentatonic scales at the same time. So we're going to be doing this in the key of B minor. We're going to be overlaying the minor and the major pentatonic scales in their first position. So here is the B minor pentatonic rooted from the 7th fret of the E string. And we're also going to be using the B major pentatonic, which is also rooted from the 7th fret of the E string. We're going to be using both of these scales at the same time, so we're going to be crossing between major and minor, so it's really, really useful to know where those crossover notes are, especially in the higher registers of the scale. So in the minor, we're playing this. And in the major, we're playing this. It's really useful to know how to play those at the same time. So here's how it looks if I play the major and the minor notes in one go. On its own, that might not sound like B.B. King, but it's the way you use those combination of minor and major notes through the things we learn in this lesson that would give you that B.B. King vibe. Second thing we're going to learn is something called the B.B. box. Now, we've already talked about this in the last video we did on the style of Peter Green, because Peter Green used this shape a lot himself. He was a big B.B. King fan. The B.B. box is a 5-note phrase that lives in the 3rd shape of the major and the minor pentatonic. So in the key of B, it's going to be here. We're going to be starting on the 13th fret of the G, playing the 12 and 14 of the B string, and the 12 and 14 of the E string. So here's the shape altogether. This little 5-note box will be essential in crafting some B.B. King style licks. If you want to move this around to different positions, look at this note here on the B string. So it's the 2nd note of the shape. In this key, that is a B because I'm playing in the key of B. Now, whatever key you want to move the B.B. box into, make sure that 2nd note is the key note. So if I want to put it in A, for instance, I want to find an A note on that string, so that would be the 10th fret. Or if I wanted to put that into the key of E, I would find an E note, which is here on the 5th fret. So you can easily transpose that around to different keys. Third thing we're going to learn is a lick. This is a B.B. King style turnaround, so this is great for kicking off or ending a blues progression. So here's what it is in full, and then we'll break it down. So this turnaround lick combines those major and minor pentatonic notes. We're starting off with this little run here on the B and E string. Then we're doing this double stop star chord here, so I'm playing the 10th fret on the E string and the 9th on the B. I'm playing this as a series of triplets, so 3 across each beat, and I'm playing it all with upstrokes. First time I play this, I'm bending the B string just slightly, and then every other hit after that I'm adding vibrato, so it just creates this slight dissonance with the notes. And then I'm landing on this 7th fret note here. You can slide that out if you want to. Then a little minor pentatonic lick here. So I'm playing the 7 on the B. I'm doing a little bend on the 10 of the B, but I'm raking into it. And then I'm landing back on that 7 with lots of vibrato. So here's the lick slowly. And once more at full speed. This next lick idea is going to use the B.B. box that we talked about. So we're playing up here at the 13th fret of the G. This next trick we're going to learn is all about how a lick resolves in a guitar solo. Now, one thing B.B. King always did is he always found his way back to the root note. This is why when you listen to his guitar licks, they always sound very resolved. He always tried to land on the note that is the key of the song. So we're going to do a couple of licks now using the BB box that we learnt, and we're going to resolve them on the key of the song, which in this case is B. So here is a simple idea, and then we'll break it down. So you'll notice that lick had two sides to it, and both of them landed on this B note here at the 12th fret. The first part of the lick is using the lower part of the BB box. Then we go to the higher register. Then the second part. Now there's a couple of little BB King traits in there as well, so even though we're landing on that root note and sliding out each time, I ended each of the phrases with a very typical BB idea. So the first time round, we resolved it from this fifth here. So we're actually playing this note here on the E string, the F sharp note, and dropping that back to the B. That's a very typical BB kind of thing. And the other thing I did was I played this E note here, and I landed on a bend on the C sharp on the B string, before resolving back on the B again. So both of those are little ideas that B.B. King uses quite a bit in his phrasing. So here's that entire lick section broken down nice and slowly. Now the cool thing with B.B. King's playing is you can play that as a slow lick like I just did there. Or you can also put some swing to it by making it up-tempo. So here's what that lick sounds like at a more up-tempo pace. Fifth BB King trick is his vibrato technique. Now you've probably been playing a bit of vibrato anyway yourself up to this point, but BB does this in a very specific way. When he does vibrato, and I'll just use the 7th fret on the B string as an example to start here, instead of keeping your hand close to the guitar like you normally would, BB actually opens his hand out completely. So when you're doing this BB King style vibrato, the only part of your hand that will actually be touching the guitar is the tip of the finger that's playing the note. So when you're playing that note, you shouldn't be connected anywhere else on the neck. Now, the way I play this is I always have the sort of side of my first finger touching the bottom of the neck just for a little bit of stability. I find that helps me. But to get this as authentic as you can, you're not touching the neck anywhere. This gets a very light vibrato. So when your hand is in this open position, your thumb is extended and your three fingers are extended like this. You may hear people refer to BB's vibrato as being like a butterfly. And the reason for that is because when your hand is in this extended position and you're moving it back and forward, it's almost like the wings of a butterfly flapping. So the whole thing is, the thumb comes down and the fingers come up. The finger's almost rotating and pivoting on that one spot. The vibrato you get doing this is incredibly subtle. I just personally, like I said, find it a little easier to anchor on the bottom, especially when I try and go a bit faster with it. So getting that vibrato technique does take a little bit of practice. It's all about the lightness of the touch. So you're not doing an extreme vibrato like this. You're just shaking that note very subtly. For the 6th trick, I'm going to reuse part of my BB box lick just to demonstrate this idea, and this is some high slide outs. So I'm going to use this little lick here again as my starting point, but I'm going to add this little slide out thing that BB King does a lot in his playing, which is this. So there I played the 19th fret of the E string twice, but I kept them nice and choppy, and on the second time, I slid it out. BB does this a lot at the end of phrases, or sometimes in the middle of phrases if there's a big gap. This note up here at the 19th fret is taken from my B minor pentatonic scale. It's my root note. You can use any note from the scale you want along that high E string, but it always works quite well to go for the octave like that. So here's how that sounds in context. It works really great just as an effect in the middle of a lick that you may already be comfortable with, and it's just a great way to fill a bit of space as well. But it also works cool as an end. And the final thing we're going to look at today is BB's use of outside notes in a jazzy fashion. So I'm going to play this lick, which uses some notes that are outside of the pentatonic scale, and then we'll break it down. So this leg is based around a minor pentatonic shape, but I'm starting off with this slide here on the 10th fret up to the 11th. This technically takes it into another major note. Then I'm coming down the minor pentatonic. Then I'm hitting the 7th fret here on the G and I'm hammering it back on, or you can slide this up to the 8th. This is a minor to a major third in theory terms. And I'm landing here on the root note of the D string. So even though the additional notes I played are major notes, you can view them as outside notes if you're playing this over a minor blues. They'll sound slightly jazzy because they're not going to be in that minor key. We're going to end the lick then with this little move here from the 6th to the 7th on the B string. And then we're going to hit the root note once again to finish on the E string. So here's the lick nice and slow. And up to full speed. You may notice I also put in a little string rake there into that first note. BB would add those little string rakes from time to time just to give certain notes impact, but I'm not particularly sure if he was doing that intentionally or if it was just a technique thing that is just an intrinsic part of his style. But you can put those little rakes in, so all I'm doing there is I'm just muting across the strings with my middle finger, and I'm playing the 10th fret on the E with my third finger. So I get that muted string run up to that note. So that's another little cool BB King thing you can throw in, those little string rakes whenever you feel like as well. So there you go guys, there are 7 BB King style tips, tricks and techniques that you can take away, put into your own guitar solos and get a little bit of that classic BB King vibe in your own playing. Thank you guys so much for watching, I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. If you did, please let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to let us know if there are any other guitar players you guys want us to focus on the styles of. We'd love to hear who you guys want to learn to play like. And don't forget to check out PMTV on YouTube for more free video lessons just like this. We've already covered a bunch of other players like Peter Green, Eric Clapton, John Mayer, and there's plenty more cool ones on the way. And don't forget to check out mgrmusic.com if you're looking for a guitar teacher in your local area. Thanks guys, I will see you soon.